the bus on the pilot quite a few times. It's very fast. It's much faster than my normal commute.
In a typical situation, like at 8:30 in the morning, this could take 20 to 30 minutes to go a mile and a half. But we're hearing from people around, you know, during the pilot is 5 to 10 minutes at the most.
It's amazingly fast. We feel safer for the cyclists that we see riding next to us. And all around, it seems to have been a great success.
On this corridor between Rossendale Village and Forest Hills, there are about 19,000 bus trips every day. Because of that, over the course of the last 3.5 weeks, we've created this dedicated lane where we've, in the morning, removed a lane of parking for 4 hours and allowed buses and bikes, whether those are school buses or MBTA buses, to have their own lanes for about a mile all the way down to Forest Hills.
We were formed about 3 years ago. One of the first things we started pushing for was this bus lane because we know how many people commute up and down this stretch of Washington Street every day. And we didn't really know the numbers, but once we found out this, that it's something like 60% of the people going through this corridor in the morning peak are on buses, we knew this was a great idea that we should keep pushing.
We worked with community members and put them in our classic orange t-shirts to go talk to their neighbors and say, hey, do you want better bus service? And when you're talking to your neighbor, you're willing to listen. And we had hundreds of people reaching out to the mayor asking for better bus service.
We love this. This is actually part of our daily commute. And so the two boys and I get on every day and go to Forest Hills and catch the orange line from there. And the difference has been huge.
They move much faster, like I said, because they don't have to flow back into the traffic, the main traffic, so they have their own lane. So it is moving much, much faster.
It moves things quicker. It not only helps move the buses, the MBTA buses quicker, school buses, and then it also helps with the regular car traffic that doesn't have to deal with buses in the same lane. So it's really a win-win all around.
One thing that I think is really important about this pilot is that it challenged perceptions of this corridor. So this pilot helped us discover how many parking spaces are truly needed in the community and how much space we could allocate to buses and bikes.
A lot of school buses are using it. Quite a few cyclists are using it. I biked it quite a bit as well. It's been very safe to ride in. I've had no issues with the buses. They seem very well trained.
What has been great is we've actually heard very positive feedback from everybody, no matter what mode they choose. So whether you're on a bus, you're driving a bus, you're riding a bike, you're in a car, this has been very popular.
It seems to have sped up the flow of traffic for everyone, and that's a great thing, both for convenience and people who are thinking about whether or not to locate somewhere in Boston, but also just for equity and economic mobility, connecting people to where they need to go, regardless of making an affordable option accessible to everyone.
Just in terms of moving people instead of vehicles, it's really important to think about sort of every corridor that way, and we think this is a great way to move more people through the corridor faster.
We absolutely want to see more pilots more quickly in the city. What we've learned through our Better Buses report is that 4 or 5 corridors with simple improvements like these could improve bus service for 100,000 people in the city. Our city is changing, and we need to try new things to move more people, and without that political will to try things that may seem hard or may seem unpopular, we're not going to get better bus service.